Hi friends, this is Dr. Abdekam Chimthanawala. Today I'll discuss one of the very, maybe sometimes infrequently used remedies, that is Nux Moschata. I'll try to discuss some of the mental symptoms which I have found very useful in my day-to-day practice, and I have got very good results with this remedy, Nux Moschata. It is normally a combination of a lot of remedies. Normally in those symptoms we think about other remedies and we forget Nux Moschata. And the first symptom that you should remember of Nux Moschata is elements from disappointed love or elements from being unhappy. Now, whenever this comes in our mind, elements from disappointed love, the first few remedies that strikes to our mind is, of course, phosphoric acid or nitromure, ignitia, staphylococcus, hyoscyamus. But do remember Nux Moschata because it has got a very, very interesting role in this type of cases. What happens after that? In Nux Moschata, the patient answers very incorrectly. His thinking pattern is disturbed and he starts answering incorrectly. You ask something, he answers something else. You ask something, he answers something else. You tell him to answer about what happened in the future, he'll tell you what happened in the past. You tell him what have you eaten today, he'll tell you what has he eaten yesterday. So he starts answering very incorrectly, and when this symptom comes, answers incorrectly, we definitely think about veratrumal, we think about phosphorus, hyoscyamus, opium, and do miss out Nux Moschata. In this way also, a Nux Moschata patient, because of this feeling for disappointed love, being unhappy, answers incorrectly, answers slowly. Now, this can only be seen in your case taking when the patient starts answering slowly. Again, but with this symptom, we think about Helleborus, we think about mercury, we think about phosphoric acid or phosphorus also, but it is Nux Moschata also answers slowly. And then it is followed by a lot of anxiety of health, you know. Lot of anxiety about the health, and the anxiety can be physical in the sense that doing restlessness of arm, fingers, anything. It can be physical anxiety also, and with physical anxiety do think about again the same drugs, phosphoric acid, phosphorus, pulsatilla, Nux Somica, or sulfur or veratrum. See how these remedies run very close in each symptoms of Nux Moschata. And then the Nux Moschata patient, because of this disappointment and answers incorrectly, forgets a lot of anxieties, it is written he starts bellowing or barking, shouts, bellowing, like we have in Cantharis, we have in Cuprum Metallica, bellowing or Belladonna. Starts speaking loudly, starts speaking out of control speech, speaks anything. It is written in Amatra Medica, bellowing or barking speech. That's all because of this behavior, and sometimes the reverse can happen. There is a lot of childish behavior in a Nux Moschata patient. So see how the remedy flows and how the mental states flows from one to another. And because of this, there is a lot of confusion, you know, confusion. And when the patient, there's so much confusion that the patient sometimes feel that whether it is happening or actually I'm dreaming about it. Whether actually I had a patient where he thought, actually, I'm at the airport to take my wife, or I'm dreaming that my wife has gone on. There's just so much confusion that everything seems to be in a dream. A very, very interesting symptom of Nux Moschata. Again, compare with phosphorus, carbovich, or cannabis indica also. So this do symptom about think about this, especially confusion about the location. Now, this symptom is very important. Confusion about the location. Where I am, whether I am at this part or this station or at that station, confusion about location, which I am at which street, is this street or no, I have to go to that street, whether this is this street which I am going to, there's a lot of confusion about location. And with this, we normally think about glonine or petroleum, but we miss out Nux Moschata. So my dear friends, a lot of symptoms which are very common to lot many of remedies, but because it is not frequently prescribed, we forget Nux Moschata. And then the patient of Nux Moschata can have lot of delusions, you know. Delusion that he has two heads. I have two heads. Or delusion that the parts are shrunken. Or delusion that parts are enlarged also. For example, there's a delusion as if the parts are shrunken, you know. So we have remedy, one of the very interesting remedy, rarely used remedy. Normally we use that remedy in for coryza, sneezing and all, that is Sabadilla. Now there are always implied symptoms with this rubric also, but I'm just going to teach you that Nux Mosquito is an important symptom. Or we have a delusion as if the body parts are enlarged feeling the patient has. Again, very similar to hyoscyamus, or opium, or stramonium, or carbovich. But remember Nux Mosquito also. Or the body part, especially he has two heads. Now, there are patients who come and tell you that I have two thinking pattern. I feel once this and one head thinking this, the other head thinking this, and immediately we think about anacardium. He has two wheels. Now, in the implied symptom of Nux Mosquito also, the patient has a delusion as if he has two heads. With this, do remember one remedy which is very, very important, that is Moschus. Moschus also has the same delusion. Nux Mosquito also has the same delusion. This is the delusion, and there are a lot of delusion then basically a Nux Mosquito patient has. But these are very, very important symptoms of Nux Mosquito. And as you go further in Nux Mosquito, because of this, lot of fear starts in the body. And the Nux Mosquito patient has a lot of fear of heart diseases. Or if you have a case of fear of heart disease, think about the symptoms of Nux Mosquito. How did that fear develop? From that anxiety or from confusion and from disappointed love or being unhappy, then you'll have the flow of events of the remedies and flow of events of that symptom which I just told you about Nux Mosquito. One of the fear that you should remember in Nux Mosquito that I have seen a lot many of patients, fear to go to sleep. Because the patient feels that if I go to sleep, I'll die. And this fear is a very, very important symptom of Nux Mosquito, but very, very importantly marked in Lachesis and Lademper also. And normally we think about Lachesis. It's a beautiful fear, a very, very interesting symptom. Fear when going to sleep, he feels that he would die. Now, these are the very, very interesting and very, very peculiar symptoms of Nux Mosquito that might be useful in your practice. Again, then because of this all fear, confusion, anxiety, and unhappiness and disappointment, love, there's mistakes. As I told you, there's confusion about location, there's mistakes in writing. He sometimes has mistakes in writing. Sometimes he writes and omits the letters. Sometimes he omits the words also. That is Nux Mosquito patient. And that's why, to sum up, it is said that a Nux Mosquito patient has basically a very quiet disposition. But one thing you have to add, quiet disposition alternating with laughing. That is Nux Mosquito for you. So these are very common symptoms of Nux Mosquito, very, very similar to lot remedies which follow each other very well, close to Nux Mosquito, but not Nux Mosquito. So these are the important mental symptoms that I've seen in Nux Mosquito that can help you in your day-to-day practice. I hope you like this video, and if you like this video, do share and subscribe. Thank you.